Hi, I'm Darren. This is Ananda and Orn. Tonight we've come for Thai barbecue. It's a buffet, all you can eat for 199 baht. We're gonna do something a little different, do a Q&A mukbang tonight and answer all the questions we get asked. Let's go find something to eat. Well, we've been up and got our food. I followed Orn around while she got hers. Some pork intestine there. Pork steaks. Prawns.
Some fish.
Fish. Chicken feet, Orn's favorite.
Enough.
Enough.
Oh no, some crab stick for.
Crab sticks for Anda.
Just get salt.
Yourself to as much sauce as you want. Three flavors. Crab sticks. Also went up, got a big mix of my favorites there and also a dish of my favorite noodles. Let's start cooking. So they bring out a Thai barbecue with a piece of pork fat on top.
A plate or a pot?
A pan or a plate, a hot plate. Call it many names in English and in Thai.
Kata.
Yes.
Only pan.
Gives the name to this style of cooking, Moo Kata. Pork for the pork fat there, which I'm smearing to lubricate the plate. And then you'll bang your meats on top.
Why today you take midnight?
Yeah, normally I do take more than that. I'm shy today. Pork steaks on there. Yes. So as I said, this is going to be a mukbang Q&A. Cook, eat and talk. And we're going to answer your questions. Yes, Amber? Yeah, they're for you. Yes, mum cooked those. So one of the questions that we regularly get asked is, how did I end up in Thailand? I came here for a holiday in 2011, loved it. Spent 22 days here in Thailand, in this area where we live here, Krabi. Absolutely loved it. Went back to Australia after my holiday, and after a couple of weeks, I found that I was missing Thailand. So I got on the internet, found some cheap flights, came back again. 10 weeks after my first trip, I arrived back in Thailand for my second holiday, which was 18 days long. So you know what I'm doing there. I'm dipping my chopsticks in the boiling water here just to sterilize them. Try some of these noodles out.
This yellow noodle,
yes. Yes, they are delicious. Ananda likes them too. He's got a mix of yellow noodles and also fried rice there on his plate. What is that you put in there? Some pork intestine. Right, got some more of that because I'm going to pinch some and put it on the top of the plate there. Do like that stuff grilled. So yeah, after my second trip to Thailand, went back to Australia and found that I was missing Thailand again, so decided I'd move here. A year after my first trip, I arrived back in Thailand with the intention of maybe staying for a year, see how long I lasted. It's been just over 7 years now that I've been here and still loving it every day. I do love living in Thailand. People often ask what I was doing when I was in Australia. I was operations manager for an industrial rubber company, and I came here and started working as a teacher. When Orn moved here, you were working at a factory in Bangkok, yeah? Before you came, she was doing quality control. They made car parts and what else? Washing machine parts.
Washing machine motor.
Washing machine motors.
And light for car.
Why did I move to Krabi is another question that I often get asked. Reason was that I'd spent my time here. I got to know some people here, made friends. I also had a friend whose wedding I came for the first time I came, and he lives here in Krabi as well. I'd known him for 15 odd years, I think, when I came for the wedding. So in short, had friends here, also loved the area here. It's so beautiful. I'm a beach person. Do like the beaches, and there's plenty of beaches here. I often meet people who live here in Krabi who lived in other areas of Thailand. They generally tell me that I'm a lot smarter than they are because I came here first, didn't go elsewhere before I moved here, came straight here. Do love Krabi, great food, great people, beautiful place. Every day I'm in awe of the scenery here. Do I miss Australia? Not yet. I've only been here 7 years, so it may happen soon, but not to date. Not missing anything. I obviously miss my friends, my family and stuff. There's no real food that I miss though. People often ask me that. Don't go anywhere without my Vegemite. Always got that whenever I got friends coming. They bring that for me. Also Tim Tams, always have them on hand as well. Friends often bring them, and there's plenty of international food here that I can get. Australian meat pies for sale pretty readily. And like I said, food from all around the world. Another question we often get asked is how we met. I did a video of that a few months back. You can see it up there. Is a link to that one if you missed that one.
Yeah.
So some questions about coming to Thailand that you guys often ask me. Where should I change money? I, to be honest, am not an expert on that. I always brought money from home, changed it here because I figure the Australian banks make squillions of dollars. They're obviously doing that somehow, probably by charging me fees. A friend recently came here. She actually changed money in Australia and said there wasn't much difference between the price that she saw here, the money exchanges, and the price she got from the bank in Australia. So up to you. Like I said, I'm no expert on that one. Where should I book tours? Generally, I think tours are much cheaper here. There's plenty of choice. It's a lot easier to get your money back if the weather is rough and they have to cancel the tour. So I would recommend that you book them here. Like I said, there's plenty of choice here. There's tour sellers everywhere and plenty of competition for pricing. So there is a moat around here. There's like a soup where you can also cook things, which I probably should do because I haven't put anything in there yet. And they give you a jug that you can fill it up with. So I've got also a tray of vegetables, bang some of those in there. You can have some seaweed. That's seaweed there. You also get bowls and spoons up there where all the food is. It's a huge buffet up there with plenty of choices, lots of seafood and different meats. Putting your chicken feet in there. Got some mushrooms. Get some of them in. Looking good. Plenty of colour in there now.
Oh, now look
me. Looks delicious. Probably the two most common questions I get asked are, when's the best time to come to Thailand? Really depends on what you like. For me, the best time is Songkran, Thai New Year. It's an awesome festival. It's also the hottest time of year, so it probably doesn't suit everyone if you don't like hot weather. Right now it's the rainy season, but there's been no rain now for, or virtually no rain for probably about 2 weeks. The weather is luck of the draw. People always ask me, when's the best weather, or what's the weather like in July, what's the weather like in October? The weather does what it wants, unfortunately. It is luck of the draw in my opinion, and it does seem to change from year to year. Some years June is perfect, some years October's perfect. The weather can do anything, and it can also be rainy in the dry season as well. I've seen that happen. No way really of predicting 100% what the weather's gonna do. Right now, as I said, it is the low season. There's lots of great deals. I was looking at hotels in this area before. There's a lot with like 85% off, 80% off, 70% off. Some real bargains now, and very, very quiet, but the weather at the moment is great. I went to the beach this morning and it was virtually deserted. I was really the only person there, but it's been a beautiful day today. It's been, yeah, sunny, a bit cloudy, but really nice weather, not too hot. There are lots of great festivals in Thailand. They're pretty good to check out as well. In November, Loy Krathong is one of my favorites as well. And also the vegetarian festival, do love that. Yeah, it is good, thank you. What about yours? You been eating?
Yes, that one.
Just started. Okay, I think my pork looks about ready there. Take that off and let it cool. Pork intestine, I'll give it a bit more time to. So you can cook the stuff either in the soup around the sides or on the grill plate there. Things I'm worried about is touching raw food with the chopsticks with this, and also touching raw meat on the cooked meat as well. I think that is pretty much the only way you can go wrong with these things. But I did have a friend get sick from this one time, but he said he ate something that he was pretty sure wasn't quite cooked through. So I guess common sense, if you use that here, you should be pretty right. All those veggies are done though. It's a lot of fun eating like this, very social. Sit down, chat with your friends, and cook and eat. And generally at this type of Thai barbecue, there's no time limit. Some of the different types of buffets in Thailand do have time limits, but these generally don't. So you can sit here and cook and eat and talk and drink all night if you want.
Cannot all night.
Not all night. Well, they close eventually.
Nearly time they close, they will come chase you.
Right, a couple of prawns in there as well. Looking good. Time for some more juice, I think. Can you pass that over, please?
Raw, can I put?
Yes, you can put. Normally I don't let her fill it up because she always overfills it, and then it runs through the little holes in the plate and into the charcoal underneath, and then our charcoal goes out. So normally I'm in control of that one. It's been about 2 years since she's had control of it. Let's see how she does tonight. More questions. What's the best and cheapest way to get around Phuket? Well, generally in my experience, those words best and cheapest don't go together so well. Normally the best way for me is my car. I have a car, so I drive that, and I would recommend renting a car. It's safest. The cheapest way is to rent a motorbike, but around 50 people per day die on motorbikes in Thailand. I wouldn't really recommend that, especially if you've never ridden motorbikes before. Thailand is not a good place to learn to ride motorbikes. Another question we get asked pretty regularly, where's the best hotel in Phuket? Where's the best hotel in Bangkok? Where's the best hotel in Krabi? I don't know, I haven't stayed in all the hotels. TripAdvisor is the place to go, or agoda.com. Look at the reviews, look for people who have stayed in these places. Find out which ones are popular. I've stayed in a limited number. There's about 1,800 hotels in Phuket, I believe. I haven't stayed in all of them. I can't tell you which one's the best, I'm afraid. Similarly, where's the best restaurant in Phuket? Again, I haven't tried all of them. I'll tell you the good ones. If you're only following us on YouTube, you are missing out on a lot of the restaurants we eat at. A lot of them only make it to Facebook or Instagram. So I'd recommend following us there, because you'll find there's a lot more recommendations there as well. The last two trips that we've been to Phuket, we haven't made any restaurant videos, but I've given you quite a few recommendations on both Facebook and Instagram. Sorry about that. Left-hander and right-hander sitting alongside each other. Not the best idea. First bits of pork there. Oh, delicious. Love this style of eating. Charcoal flavor, so yummy. Also the soup flavor with the prawns and things and fish pieces. one of my favorite styles of eating in Thailand. We haven't been to one of these places for a while now, but we used to come here about every week or so. We all love it. They also have unlimited Thai desserts and unlimited ice cream, which we all like as well. This is Ananda's latest fashion idea. I'm sweating here because it's pretty hot and humid, but he seems to be cold. He's all rugged up there. Next question, what's the best thing about living in Thailand? For me, it's the people. Thai people are awesome, as a lot of you know. I've got lots of Thai friends who I adore. Got a Thai wife who I adore. Generally, most people you meet here are adorable. The food also, you may have noticed, I'm kind of partial to. Like I mentioned before, I live in a beautiful area. The landscape here in Krabi is quite amazing. Yeah, what do you got? Your helicopter that you made. And in general, in comparison to the West, life here is reasonably cheap and affordable. People say it's getting expensive. Well, it seems to be getting expensive everywhere. It's not just Thailand. Whenever I go back to Australia, I do notice that things are going up in price each time, it seems. I think that fish is done. Take that out. Good Mukata, yeah?
Yeah.
Don't think we've ever had a bad one.
With here, nah, never.
Yeah, with here, never. But yeah, it can be a bit average sometimes. We do like the charcoal. Some of them are electric. It doesn't give you the same flavor. And this one has choices we like. Orn loves the chicken feet, which is the main reason that we come here. Explosion there. It's time for more. Bit of egg tofu in there. More of your pork belly.
Yes.
You want to put it on? Stop the plate from burning. Put a wonton-y thing there. And lots of mussels. Yeah, one of the main keys with these things is keep stuff on it to stop it blackening, stop it burning. Vine leaves in there as well. As I said, this is all you can eat. It's a good idea not to fill your plate too much the first time you go up, because if you waste food here, you do have to pay, and it's not cheap. It's about 30 baht, I think, per piece if you don't eat what you take. So go up as many times as you want. Just don't leave a plate full of food.
You can go up many times if you want, if you're not shy.
Yes, if you're not shy. I'm not very shy.
Your shrimp already cooked,
nah? My shrimp already cooked, yes.
Not easy to open.
No. Your pork intestine looks good there. I might have to sample a piece if that's okay.
This salt.
Mm-hmm. Good?
Eat with kimchi.
Eat with whatever. I'm not a traditionalist. More veggies. Another great thing about living here is that I am never cold. Never been a big fan of winter. Winter here is about 28 degrees Celsius. The heat can get a bit much at times. Just come out of about 3 months of every day over 35 degrees Celsius. That wasn't nice, but we survived somehow. My favorite Thai food is another question that comes up quite a lot. Featured it in a few of my videos now. It's khao soi chiang mai noodle. If you come to Thailand, make sure you try that one out. A lot of you would know it. Very, very popular amongst foreigners. And absolutely amazing. Love that one. Is everything delicious in Thailand is another question I get asked pretty regularly, because I guess I seem to like it all. Well, more or less everything is delicious. We met a subscriber a couple of years ago who was here on his first trip to Thailand, and he said that was one of the things that blew him away. He'd been a chef for many years, said eating here, it was pretty hard to find average food. There's a few dishes that I'm not so keen on. usually won't eat them, but most stuff I do love in Thailand. And in fact, after I came here for the first holiday, when I went back to Australia, I started cooking Thai food at home almost every night. Do you eat Thai food every day? Pretty much, I think. We eat Thai food every day. You do?
Yes.
Yeah. What Western foods do you like?
Spaghetti. Burger with no veg.
With no veg. Not wedge.
Burger with no veg.
Veg.
Pizza. Pizza okay, nah, but not very love. Nah.
No. And KFC. Yeah. The only time I eat KFC is when she wants that. Do I ever get bored of Thai food? No, not yet. It's only been 7 years so far. So it may happen, but I'm still discovering new foods pretty regularly. Got a lot of favorites, a lot of stuff that I crave like this. Been craving this for a while now. So no, definitely not bored of Thai food yet. Still enjoy eating it pretty much every day, more or less every meal. Is street food safe? Yeah, in my opinion, it's pretty safe. You can get food poisoning anywhere. The people I know who've got sick all seem to think that it came from their hotel restaurant. One got sick once on her favorite Thai soup. I'm surprised she doesn't get sick every time because one of the ingredients is raw pork blood that they pour into it. She got sick on that once in Phuket. I did have some stomach issues recently after some street food, but I've been stupid with it. I bought it, took it home, sat it on the cupboard for 6 or 8 hours, then put it in the fridge where it sat for another 4 days. Then I took it out and microwaved it, and I had some stomach issues after that one. But that's pretty much the only time I've been sick from street food. And that wasn't the food's fault, that was my stupidity. I can't comment on street food in other countries. I haven't eaten it, but get the impression that it's not as safe as it is here in Thailand. I will have a street food safety video coming fairly soon with a lot more details on that. Another regular comment is, I've got a seafood or gluten or peanut allergy. What can I eat safely? In my opinion, nothing really. Take some precautions. There are no standard recipes here in Thailand. Everyone might make things differently. What I recommend doing is what a friend of mine did. She printed up a little card that she took with her. I'm allergic to seafood. She translated it on Google Translate into Thai, carried it everywhere. I'm allergic to seafood. Do not give me seafood. If I eat seafood, I die. Worked well. She didn't get any seafood. She went back to Australia alive and well. That's what I'd recommend doing. There's lots of information on that sort of stuff on the internet. So do a bit of Googling. There's also some sites where they've got those printable cards as well. So you can do it quite easily. You've just got to print it off. That would be my advice. Don't trust any recipe. Is the fruit safe in Thailand? The cut fruit. I've read a lot of stuff which says don't trust the cut fruit. I didn't trust it for a long time. I've eaten that now for a number of years without any problem. I think a lot of the information on that sort of stuff is possibly outdated, old information. But if you're worried about it, don't eat it. Or go to 7-Eleven, go to one of the variety stores, get yourself a cheap little carving knife, cut the fruit yourself or cut it in your hotel room and try it out there if you're worried.
I can cut yourself.
Better safe than sorry.
I'll cut yourself.
Yes, better not to do that. Unfortunately, we had some technical issues with this video, so that's all we got for you for this week. If you've got any other questions, put them in the comment section below because we'll have another Q&A coming soon. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week. Bye.